Dear friends, welcome to the starting course of the Meditation Steps project. This video is the most important. I'm going to explain the basic technique of meditation. This technique is pleasant, efficient, and it is very complete. This is a unique speciality of this course, because this technique is based on the classical Raja Yoga. Classical Raja or Raja Dhiraj Yoga, the royal yoga, the yoga of the mind. So all the parts of yoga are incorporated in our course. In this video, I'm going to explain just a technique. There are some additional videos on this level, and I advise you to watch them. There is a video about mantra, why we use the sound in meditation. Sound is the vehicle, the main core of meditation. Mantra means mantra. Mind liberates. Something which liberates the mind, elevates the mind. So I am explaining in detail how exactly the mantra does it, how the mantra liberates the mind. Then there is a video about music and meditation, whether to use the music or not to use the music, how to relax or not to relax in meditation. And there is a video, very important one, it's called Theory of Meditation. How exactly meditation works. So watch them also. Now, reserve some time. I will explain the meditation and you start practicing meditation immediately. Because if you will postpone, oh, okay, I will do tomorrow, then tomorrow may come after several years. So after listening this explanation, allocate 5 minutes, sit and experience it. Do it. This is very, very important. So how to do meditation? The main essence of the meditation practice is the psychological law. As you think, so you become. So what we want? We want to evolve. We want to expand, we want to better ourselves. As you think, so you become. In meditation, we need to remove undesirable objects, objects that keeps us in the limited state, in the limited shape, that condition us to the limitedness. And after removing those objects, which are limiting us, we need to connect with the idea of infinity. In this way, the mind will constantly develop and grow. And you will feel it. You will see, after half a year, you will notice, oh, somehow I became very wise. How did that happen? I didn't notice. Because the mind is expanding, and you are able to understand many more things that you used to. So the technique of meditation is like that. The first portion, removing undesirable objects. We will use imagination in the beginning. You need to imagine yourself in a beautiful place, just like this. You are sitting on top of the mountain. You are sitting by the ocean, in the desert, somewhere. It is very expanded feeling. Why do we use imagination? Because we need to cut off the connection of the sensory organs with the external world. You will notice that when you are at your home, you feel one way. When you are in the nature, you feel another way. You are in your friend's home, you feel another way. You are at your job, is another feeling. So the environment conditions us, changes our mental flow, and we need to remove that influence of the environment. So through imagination, remove it. Imagine a beautiful place. It's just like you read the book, and after some time, you start to daydream, and you're not reading anymore. Your eyes looking seeing the book, seeing the letters, but your mind is not seeing. You are seeing the mental projection of your imagination. It means your organs, the sensory organs, have become disconnected from the external environment. This is what we want to achieve. So you imagine a beautiful place. There has to be two things. First, the place should be very big, vast. You should feel that wherever I will go, there won't be any obstacle. And second, you feel that you are living, you are there all alone. Nobody is there. And just enjoy that. I'm sitting all alone. Nobody can disturb me. I have, let's say, 10 or 15 minutes, and I don't have to do anything. It's a beautiful feeling when I don't have to do anything. Maybe I have some things to do. Those things are all very important, and I will do those things after 15 minutes. But these 15 minutes that I take for meditation will not harm in any way my activity. Rather, it will rejuvenate me. So these 15 minutes, I don't have to think anything. I'm allowed to be in peace. This is a beautiful feeling. And you have to learn how to create this feeling. Because many times people will sit in meditation and they force themselves to meditate. Oh, I should not think of anything. No, you should think differently. I'm allowed not to think of anything. I can do it. I can afford it. Beautiful, fantastic. And then you relax completely. So imagine a beautiful place. After you are satisfied with that imagination, after you feel that you are not in the room, the walls have disappeared, I am in that vast place, all alone. After you get this feeling, forget the imagination. Don't imagine anymore. And concentrate on the breath. You breathe in, observe, inhaling, you breathe out, observe, exhaling. You will discover how beautiful it is just to breathe. You breathe in, you enjoy that, it is very peaceful, and you breathe out, you also enjoy it. And then for some time, 1 minute, just observe your breath, going in and going out. Now your mind is ready for deeper practice, for the connection with infinite idea. The infinite idea is represented through mantra. Mantra is the sound. The sound itself changes the vibration of the mind. I have experimented many times. I am giving classes, seminars, lectures, and very often I will ask people, okay, before the class starts, let us sing. And I will sing the mantra, they will sing along with me. I will tell them, please observe your feelings. What is going on within you? And we will sing. And then I will ask, how did you feel? They'll say, oh, I felt very light. I felt my mind is growing, my mind is expanding. I felt kindness and love. Then I tell, yes, this is exactly the feeling of the mantra, the idea of the mantra. And even without knowing the idea of the mantra, the sound itself brings the mind in the special wave. It elevates the mind. It changes. So in the beginning, you just repeat the mantra, the sound of the mantra. We will use universal mantra called Baba Nam Kevalam. Baba Nam Kevalam. You can read on the screen. It is written Baba Nam Kevalam. So you sit with the closed eyes. And you repeat, Baba Nam Kevalam. And listen. Repeat and listen. Within yourself. No, the mouth is not moving. You are not pronouncing it externally. It is all mentally. Mentally done. Then, when you are satisfied that you are concentrated on the mantra, then start to go into the meaning of the mantra, the feeling of the mantra. The translation of the mantra is Supreme Consciousness is all there is. There is nothing but only the Supreme Consciousness. This is a bit abstract. What is this Supreme Consciousness? I don't know. So we will use more understandable terms. When a yogi, when an experienced practitioner comes and touches with the deeper reality within himself, which is called Supreme Consciousness, he feels, he will express, he'll say, oh, this is love. This is a very profound love. Or this is joy, radiant joy, or very profound peace. So all of that is Supreme Consciousness. Supreme Consciousness is one thing, having many, many, many sides, many faces. So we can go from those different sides, approaching that idea of Supreme Consciousness. So you can feel love is all there is. I know what is love. I love somebody. I love my parents, I love my children, I love my husband, I love my wife. So let me feel that, let me multiply this love. I love every particle of this universe, everything in this universe and everything beyond this universe. And universe, every particle of this universe loves me also. I'm slowly merging with this love, become one with that love. So how is it to be love? Or you come from the side of joy, happiness. I repeat the mantra, and mantra awakens this idea in me. I know that when I repeat the mantra, I have to deepen the idea. Happiness. How is it to be happiness? I am happiness. Within me and outside me, there is nothing but the flow of happiness. Let me feel it. Let me experience it. And you repeat the mantra. And you repeat, like you say, any word, let's say, a phone or bicycle. When you say, a bicycle, the image of the bicycle comes in your mind. And the concept of the bicycle comes in your mind. So, slowly, slowly, you will train your mind when you repeat Bhavanam Kevalam. So, this concept of joy comes in your mind. Only the joy is there. Only the love is there, only the peace is there. And then you meditate. Meditate means meditatio, the Latin word, to think deeply. So you think deeply about the joy, about the happiness, about love, about peace. And then you repeat, you go deeper into that idea. And as you think, so you become. You may believe it, you may not believe it, or love is all there is. What? What love is all there is? I don't believe it. Don't have to believe. If you explore it, and you repeat it, and you try to feel it, as you think, so you become. At least you will become love. You will become happiness. You will become positivity. And with that positivity, you will acquire so much strength and power and energy and drive in your life. So that is important. And then later on, you will discover that, yes, actually, with the eyes, with the new eyes, you look at the world and you will see so much beauty there. So love is all there is, this auto-suggestion. So you meditate like this. You sit in the posture. It is important to keep the spine straight. Close the eyes. There is another big explanation coming later on in the course about the posture, about the importance, how to sit. All the details, all the nuances will be there. But for now, it's just good to know that I sit with the cross legs, with a straight spine. I curl my tongue within the mouth. The lower portion of the tongue touches the palate of the mouth. So you sit there. You sit quiet. I'm allowed to sit, not to think about anything, not to worry about anything. I'm allowed. I can have my 15 minutes. Then you sit and then you imagine beautiful place. I am all alone there and it is very expanded. Once you're satisfied with that, you turn your attention to the breath. Observe inhaling and observe exhaling. Enjoy your breath. Calm, beautiful. Then start mentally reciting the mantra. Baba Nam Kevalam. Concentrate on the sound. Just flow with the sound. Become sound. Then with every repetition, start to create ideation of the mantra. Baba Nam Kevalam. Joy is all there is. How is it to be joy? How is it to be peace? Let me feel it. Let me experience it. Do I know what is peace? I don't know, but I want to know. An absolute motionless state. Let me experience it. Motionless silence, which is joy, which is love. Let me experience it. And then you meditate like that. You repeat the mantra. Your homework. Make a rule for yourself that you will meditate twice a day. Don't require to meditate long time from yourself. It's not psychological. Make a rule that you will meditate for 5 minutes. But then no compromise. 5 minutes I will do. And then you can sit, after 5 minutes, you can sit 15, 20 minutes, as much as you enjoy. But for sure, I will do 5 minutes. Our mind is very inventive. It will invent. I'm tired, I have no energy. No, today, I'm not in the mood of meditation. Or I have things to do. But if there is this rule, 5 minutes, there are no excuses. You know that 5 minutes you can always find. And then you sit for 5 minutes. And even if you sit really only for 5 minutes, you will get so much benefit. You will start to discover new things about yourself, about attitudes, how the attitudes can be improved and changed. So then slowly, slowly, as you meditate, meditation becomes very valuable for you. Just like when I started to meditate. I discovered after some time, maybe after 1 week, I discovered that my mood is really improving. I start to laugh and joke and so much joy in me. And I became a likable person. People like me. So, as a young man, I like then people when people like me. So, before going to a party, I will meditate. Going to the examination, I must concentrate. I must be focused and positive. I will meditate. And I was doing like that. And then at one nobody was really guiding me. Somebody taught me this meditation and then I was just sporadically doing it. But then a thought came to my mind. I should do it every day. Why only at important occasions? Every day I should be positive. And I started, and it has become such a valuable thing for me that even somebody will tell me, oh, you don't have to do meditation. No, I need to do my meditation. This is like brushing the teeth, taking bath. It is, you know, keeping... It's like you brush the teeth. Why? Because you respect other people and you respect yourself. Otherwise, no, not nice. No, then there is no fresh feeling. So meditation is similar. You respect yourself and you respect others. You brush your mind. And with that beautiful mind, you come and interact with other people. You interact with life. So at least 5 minutes. If you brush your teeth for 3 minutes, 4 times a day, then at least for 5 minutes in the morning and evening, brush your mind. Inculcate the idea of infinite positivity. So this is your homework. Twice a day, 5 minutes. If you want to sit more after that 5 minutes, by all means, sit more. Later on in the course, there will be 10 sessions. I will explain different techniques, different secrets, how to improve concentration, how to improve health, how to manage and control emotions. This will be also important. In the next video, I will talk about the philosopher's stone of meditation, of life, ability to concentrate. If you have ability to concentrate, you are successful. You will be successful, definitely. If you don't have that ability, then you have everything, but you have nothing. So I will explain how the meditation develops the concentration and how, what to pay attention to, what should be the attitude in meditation. And that is also really life-changing video. So we'll see you on the next level. Meditate to come to the next level faster. Thank you very much. Namaskar.